Hello, my name is Felix Schaller. I am the inventor of the aeroflexible wind turbine. The aeroflexible wind turbine is a special air blade that is capable to adapt itself on the given aerodynamic condition. The idea itself originated by the discovery that stall is not really described in the modern aerodynamics and behaves mystical still today, and only can be described by numerical simulations, but these simulations do not tell the really reason of stall. So I developed my own theory, which is also published separately on this YouTube channel, where you can find out more about the theoretical background of the aeroflexible airfoil. Finally, I could show that with this constellation of the aeroflexible surface on the backside of the wing, the lift can be improved about 20% in this little constellation. Also, it shows that drag is also reduced. Equipped with these results, I could convince Aniprop, the inventor of Festo SmartBird, to make more precise research on the aeroflexible wing. And so I could make measurements in their wind tunnel, and the results showed again improvement in the aeroflexible behavior. So there was a real good argument for the aeroflexible airfoil construction. This is the resulting diagram, and it shows again a improvement of about 40% against normal NACA 0014 at 4 meters per second. I then made up my mind what could be the best reachable technology, how to apply such an aeroflexible airfoil in a technology. So I thought that a wind energy and wind turbine blades would be the most easiest way how to get into a first minimal viable product and into a first technology. So with the help of some friends, we developed a certain blade construction, how we attach a aeroflexible surface on a wind turbine blade. Therefore, we built up a construction set on a truck where we could make measurements with this wind turbine, and by that can get result and compare original blades with our modified aeroflexible blades. So I started constructing a rig for a wind turbine, how we can mount this on a smaller 3.5 ton truck. The final result looked like this, and helped us to make many measurements to improve our blade step by step by many construction versions. Here you can see how we mount our anemometer. It's a hot wire anemometer which is capable to measure very fine wind changes. And so we measured and measured, finally getting a lot of data, how we can compare our aeroflexible prototype with a original wind turbine blade. First, we started with an original blade, a naked blade, unmodified, as a reference, so we can always take reference on this blade results and compare our modified aeroflexible prototype with this original blade. We did these measurements of the original blade every time for each improved prototype, so we have always a proper reference on the given prototype. So now we started to develop our first prototype, which is having a feather-like surface on the backside of the wing, on the blade. And so we mounted this on our wind turbine and made our first measurements. But very fast we found out that a feather-like construction is not very useful for a rotating constellation which has a lot of centrifugal forces, which we actually underestimated so far, and by that the aerodynamic effects stood very, very strongly back in comparison to the centrifugal forces. The idea for a feather-like construction was originally that when a lamellar element or feather element lifts up on a certain point, because the detachment of the aerodynamics happens on a very local point, that then stretching sideways or orthogonal to the streaming direction is causing the material to stretch. And therefore we wanted to have a detached construction, but in this term the detached construction to stretch the surface sideways was not useful, and so we turned back to a lamellar construction where we do not have this single scale-like construction, but a continuously constructed lamella from the axis to the tip of the blade, almost, which gave us much better results. But first, you can see here a camera mounted in the axis point of the rotor, so we can research more the deformation of the aeroflexible surface during operation of the rotor blade. This first prototype was already deformed by centrifugal forces in this stage, so we have already a very rough surface, but still it works out for a little research to observe the deformation of the aeroflexible surface during the rotation and operation in the aerodynamic situation of the rotor. We later repeated this with a lamellar construction. This is later shown in the video. Here you can see now our second prototype. We replaced our feather-like construction with a lamella construction with ribs installed in it, but having a continuously material from the axis to the tip almost, and thereby is no longer affected onto the centrifugal forces. According to the centrifugal forces, we were very satisfied with the result. The blade result were much better and almost had the same result as the original blade. But as you can see at the axis, nearby the axis, the lamella is lifting off and being pulled away also in the due to the centrifugal forces. And because we were not satisfied with the result, what we have seen so far in the rotor blade test, we made some laboratory tests with the lamella construction, finally wanting to see the lamellas to lift off at stall. So we moved most of the ribs or make it very flexible, so we can finally see the desired effect, that we see the elements to lift off and detach flow, and then attaching again when the flow is attached and laminar. So here we can see this on the rotor operating. At the start we have the lamellas being detached and avoiding reverse flow, and then finally when the rotor starts rotate, they attach to the surface again and finally form a smooth and resistless surface. Here again a measurement where the camera is mounted on the wind turbine's console, observing the rotor blade from the back side. And here we can clearly see the lamellas operating, and when the rotor starts they are detached and avoiding the reverse flow situation, and finally attach very smoothly, almost very flat, with only little artifacts. And the leftover artifacts are clearly laminar separation bubbles, which always detach on that part of the wing and usually create vortices. We believe that without proof, that by that constellation we can reduce these detachment of vortices after the laminar separation and give the aerodynamics possibility to smoothly adapt again to the surface, which explains in our position the very good performance of this aeroflexible surface rotor. Here you can see a resulting diagram with power curves. The green power curve shows a original blade, where the orange curve is showing our aeroflexible rotor blade. Also, the startup time is very impressive. You can see a comparison of the starting point of a original blade, which takes 33 seconds until the rotor starts rotate on a given speed, while the aeroflexible rotor blade only needs 17 seconds to start rotating to this given speed. Here again, I created a visual representation of the different starting points at the same speeds. So we have the same speeds and same starting points, but you can see that rotors starting according to their aeroflexible surface constellation or after a different time. So the fastest was our third prototype, which already had the very flexible laminars mounted on its backside. Here again we compared all the different prototype results against each other. The blue curve was our first prototype, the green our second, the stiff lamellas, and the red curve was our best result, the very flexible lamella constellation. And you can see that it is very close to the beats optimum. Satisfied with these results, we thought it's now time to move to the next step and put our aeroflexible wind turbine on a real pole in nature and give it the circumstances of a real condition. Unlike the truck constellation, it was a bit confusing in the first point that the much more turbulent conditions made the airfoil to perform not as good as on the truck setup. We improved our airfoil again and created a more robust setup. Also, we made use of laser cutter. With the use of laser cutter, we could produce much more precise parts of lamellas. These types of lamellas could again improve our desired results on the behavior of the rotor blades, especially when it comes to a more turbulent wind condition. When we oppose the wind turbine to the real situation in operation, by mounting the wind turbine on an ordinary mast. By that constellation, we could get also real good data out of real wind situation where we have to deal with a lot of fluctuation in the wind. This lowers the overall performance of a wind turbine, and we wanted to see that by our stall reducing construction of the wind turbine blade, we can show that we can exploit much more wind out of the fluctuations. We again mounted the camera onto the axis of the rotor, and with our new prototype want to observe the behavior of our aeroflexible surface. At the beginning of the rotation you can see that the lamellas are working very strongly with the flow detachment and really well detach on a float attachment, and finally attach again onto the blade again to form a smooth surface. Also, what you can impressively see is that the aeroflexible surface is slightly pulsing according to the different aerodynamic conditions which exist at the different orientation of the rotor blade. At the very top, the blade risen up into the sky, there is a different aerodynamic situation than when the blade is showing down. When showing down, we have the situation that we have the mast as an obstacle, which creates a different aerodynamics than on the top, where we have a free stream. According to this situation, we also can see the deformation of the aeroflexible surface. Unfortunately, we can see on higher speed unwanted flattering effects of the elements, which shows us that the surface there is not optimally configured. So it would request to improve a little bit the stiffness of the surface material at these parts, especially on the more remote or outside laying lamellas. This effect is much stronger than on the inside of the blade. It also created noises, and therefore we have to improve this construction at that point more. Overall, the surface behavior was performing as we expected, and we were very satisfied with this result, and we would then need to improve the surface in that aspect that it reduces or it avoids the fluttering effect at higher speeds. So after measuring a while in open air conditions, we got a lot of data and could outvalue these data into a diagram. The data was not as good as we expected it, but it had very interesting aspects in the data itself, where we could clearly see the effect working and could clearly see an improvement in the fluctuation compensation and much more. Also, we could see when the fatigue of the material improved a bit, also the performance of the wind turbine, and a lot more results we got out of the measurements. Finally, the quality of the data, the overall quality, was not as good that we could create a precise analysis of the performance of the aeroflexible rotor blade in this situation. Thanks for watching this video.